Hello and welcome to my next YouTube session. Today we have a really cool session about security features which are included in Azure Active Directory Premium 2. Okay, before we start, I'd like to give you a short introduction about me. My name is Hannes Lager-Grüner. I'm a multi-cloud architect in one of the biggest consulting companies in Austria. I'm working since 2012-2013 with public cloud, mainly focused on Microsoft Azure. You can see it also on my certification levels. And over the time, I'm realizing it's a good idea to go more broader. So I'm also specialized and certificated into AWS and GCP too. You can find my social profile in Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, Xing. I have also for sure my private blog, cloudblogger.at, and for sure my YouTube channel. Okay, enough from me, so let's start with the topic from today. Today we talk about Azure Active Directory Premium 2, the Privileged Identity Management feature itself. So this is from video type nugget and from video category level 300. So we are going more deeper into technical details. Okay, this agenda from today is, first of all, we have to discuss what kind of license models are available in Azure Active Directory. There are different models, there are different license type based on your requirements. Then we are go one step further and talk about what is privileged identity management, why should I use it, and a next step for why and for who the privileged identity management is the perfect solution. And at the end, I hand over to my live environment and show you, okay, how does privileged identity management performs in real life. Okay, so let's start with the agenda, with the topic license model in Azure Active. There are different license models available. So first of all, the free license model, it's perfect for dev test environments. So you have the minimum subset of functionality. Keep in mind, you don't have an SLA. You have a limit of object inside Azure Active Directory. The limit is really high. So we have, I guess, 500,000 objects is the maximum in the free license. Then we are going one step further and have the Office 365 apps license. You can buy this exactly. This is included in Microsoft 365 E1, E3, E5 and F5 licenses. So you get automatically the Office 365 app Azure Active Directory licenses. Then we have the Azure Active Directory Premium 1 feature or license, which includes a basic subsets, so the same like free license, same like Office 365 and premium features. And this is the license which we are recommend for each of our customer as a basic license level. And then we have on top the Premium 2 license, which includes for today the feature which we will discuss today, privileged identity management, for example, and much features more. Each license is also included, or the license Premium 1 or Premium 2 are also included in different license bundles like EMS, Enterprise Mobility Suite, E3, the Premium 1, E5, the Premium 2 license. And also the Microsoft 365 also includes the Premium 1 or Premium 2 feature. So keep this in mind when you have the license discussion, what are the best license options for me, that the premium licenses are also included in some bundle licenses. So this is a real important part. Okay, enough from license model. This is not a technical part. This is a license part. It's not really my focus, focus specialization. So let's go ahead and talk about what is PIM. PIM is a service to manage, control, and monitor access to Azure roles, Azure Active Directory roles, and also for Azure Active Directory resources. You have the ability to provide just-in-time privileged access to Azure AD and Azure Active Directory resources. So just-in-time only, now and time-bound. So you can assign a permission, and the permission is only available for the next, for example, 2 hours, and then the permission will automatically removed from the user. You have also the ability to enforce multi-factor authentication to when you activate your rule, depending on your role, you can say, okay, for example, you want to enable the global administrator roles, the highest role in Azure Active Directory, you have to enforce, you can enforce the multi-factor authentication. So the user open the Azure portal, log in, username and password, enable the role itself, and now the Privileged Identity Management service will say, okay, it's fine, you are logged in, but you have to validate your user account with a multi-factor authentication too. And for sure, you can configure fine granular notification when the Privileged Identity Management roles are activated for users. So you can say, I want to send a notification to each admin, to each management user, and so on and so on. Okay, then let's go ahead. Why and for who should I enable Privileged Identity Management? So, why? It's really easy. You can implement just-in-time access and least privilege, the least privilege concept. So keep in mind, Azure Active Directory is a global service, so you can log in from everywhere if you have it configured. And this is the reason, and this is one reason why we should implement the least privilege concept. So the user only gets the permission which are needed. And Privileged Identity Management helps to implement privileged identity, least privilege concept, and also the just-in-time access. It reduces for sure the people who have access to secure information. So keep this in mind. You have the ability to say, okay, you have now the permission to activate Global Administrator. 1 month later or 3 months later, I will start an access review. Do you need this permission right now? If no, send me an email or say, okay, no, we don't need this permission anymore, and you removed, we remove the permission automatically. We have also the ability to implement an approval process. So for example, for the global administrator role, which is a really high level role, high secure level role, it will be a good idea to implement an approval process. So for example, you want to activate the role, and your manager have to approve the request before you get the role. So you can implement this workflow really simple. And for who is this permission? Normally for everyone, but this means each user of your company need a premium 2 license. My recommendation is minimum for high privileged users. So for global administrator, for user administrator, for all administrative role, please enable also the Privileged Identity Management service, and also assign a Privileged Identity Management Azure Active Directory Premium 2 license. Okay, I have here a typo. You don't need the Premium 1 license, you need the Premium 2 license to enable Privileged Identity Management. Okay, we are now ready with a short overview, a short theory overview about Privileged Identity Management. We are now switch over to my live demo and take a look, get an overview about Privileged Identity Management, where I can find the service, what can I do with different roles, with Azure Active Directory roles, and also with Azure resources, what option do I have? And then we start request Azure Active Directory role, a single role or a role group. And then we are going one step further and request Azure resource access. Okay, that's it from the theory session. Let's hand over. Okay, we are now in my demo environment. You can see here I've opened the Privileged Identity Management service itself. You can find the service in all services and also under the search bar. You can also pin the service to your favorite bar, depends on your preference. On the left side, you can see here the task area. This is the task for you. So my roles, my requests, my approval requests, my access refuse. And also a manage part, the management or the configuration part for Azure Active Directory roles, for Azure resources, and for privileged access group. Keep this in mind. This is a currently a preview feature. Okay, so let's start with the Azure Active Directory roles. So switch here and also switch to the manage part, to the roles part. I've configured one role for the Privileged Identity Management service. This is the user administrator role. You can see here on the overview screen, there are eligible assignments, there are active assignments, and there are expired assignments. Okay, eligible assignment is the way you can add or can assign a user to an Azure Active Directory role. This is an eligible assignment, and the user have the ability to request this role over a specified time. In this case, I have one user assigned, and we have also active assignment. In a good and in a real life world, there are no active assignment because this is a permanent assignment. So the user have this assignment permanently, and yes, this is the default, the normal way. And here I also have the expired assignment. We will see this later on in the configuration. Okay, then we have the description. The description itself for the Azure AD role. So this is the same like the Azure Active Directory role view. You can see here what kind of permission does this role have. And at the end, we have the role settings. So we switch here over to the edit configuration, edit role settings. And we see here on the first screen, on the first wizard screen, we have the ability to define the maximum duration for the activation. This is in this case 4 hours. Also, the on-activation requires, so we enforce multi-factor authentication when a user activates this role. We also enforce a required justification on activation, so the user have to add some informations. Why does he need this permission now? We can also enable required ticket information on activation. And at the end, we also have the ability to require approval for activation. So we have here the ability to select approver one or more to enable or to approve the user role or the Azure Active Directory role activation. So in this case, I leave this as it is and go to the next point, the assignment. So how long is the assignment available? How long can you assign this role? This is the settings here. So you have the ability to permanent assign this role to an user as eligible. So the user have permanently the option to activate the role. You also have the ability to allow permanent active assignment. So this is not the good part here, but I need this in my test environment. I've activated this. If you remove this section here, you can define, okay, how long does the permanent active assignment, when the active assignment expires. And at the end, you can define, okay, when I assign and when I enable an active assignment, require the multi-factor authentication and also a required justification on active assignment. So you have to add a comment why you do this. And at the end, we have the ability to notificate on different levels. So first of all, we can notificate some users when members are assigned as eligible role. So when you add a new eligible role, a new user to the eligible, to this role as eligible, you can notificate different users. You also have the ability to notificate when a member is assigned as an active user to this role. And at the end, we have the ability to send a notification when the user itself activates the eligible role for this role for this assignment. Okay, let's switch back to our privileged identity management. I want to show you now the user capabilities. So I'm switch over to another session, and you can see here I'm now logged in with the test well managed user, and the test well managed user have no option to open the Azure Active Directory because the user don't have any permissions. This is the is a normal user, and the user now need the user administrator role to administrate the users in Active Directory. So we hand over to the privileged identity management service and take a look to the My Role section here. And here you can find, you can see under the Azure Active Directory role, I have here the user administrator role available as eligible assignment. And I can click here on activate assignment. And I cannot activate the assignment because we enforce, keep this in mind, we enforce for this role multi-factor authentication. The user is logged into the portal with username and password, okay? And now we require additional verification requirements to activate this role. So I click here on continue, and I get now the multi-factor authentication. Sorry. Now we have the multi-factor authentication, click on approve. And you can see now we are validated and can assign the role. So I change the duration time to 1/2 hour and type the reason test PIM. And click on activate, and you can see here there's a 3-stage process, so it takes some time, a few seconds, and when the process is finished, the activation is finished, the browser will be refreshed in 5 seconds and you get the role. So the activation is now finished, the browser will be refreshed in a few seconds, it's now done, and now we can switch back to the Azure Active Directory. We will see here in active assignments, now the role is activated for the next half an hour. And now we can switch back to the Azure Active Directory, and you will see I'm now able to start my configuration task, and I have assigned the user administrator role. Okay, I switch back to my privileged identity management and remove my active assignment. So in this case, I deactivate this assignment here because I want to show you once more. I want to show you the following. So we have another option here. Click on roles. And I'm sorry, not here. Privileged identity management, privileged access groups. We have here the option, the same option. We have here an Azure Active Directory group, and we have one assignment, one member for this group. This is the same user as the test well managed user. And I want to show you now what does this mean with this role. So I'm switched to the Azure Active Directory, also to my groups, and here to the Azure role, EED role user admin. So keep this in mind, this is a preview feature. And in this role, I have more than one assignment. So I click here on assigned roles. And you can see here, I have here 3 active assignments. I have the guest inviter, the user, global reader, and the groups administrator. So when you want to add the ability to that the user can assign more than one role in one step, you can do this with the group assignment. So switch back to the privileged identity management, switch back to my user session here, test well managed user. And here I have the option to privileged access groups. And here you can see I have one group. This is the AED user admin, or AED role user admin group. And I can click on activate. Same process. I'm now validated because my token have the second token, the second multi-factor token. Inside I have here the option of 2 hours only. Change it to a half an hour. Add a reason. Click on activate. Also, the three-step process takes some time. The refresh is starting. So, refresh is done. I can switch back to my Azure Active Directory. I have now the ability to open the Azure Active Directory, but not with the user administrative rights. So instead, I have three different roles. In this case, my assignment is guest inviter, user global reader, and groups administrator. Perfect. It works really perfect, really simple to configure, really simple to activate from the user perspective. It's awesome. Okay, so now we have the Azure Active Directory roles in place. So let's take a look to the resource group. My user don't have any resource groups in place or to configure. Switch back to the administrative task here. We have here the ability to assign Azure resources. So let's go to the resource tab and search for resource group. I've configured a resource group with the name okay, here we have the resource group itself. You can see here there are different roles available. For sure, all Azure active, all Azure roles are available to assign or to give an eligible task. We have here the assignment itself. You can see here I have one user. This is my test well managed user, is eligible. I have an eligible assignment. And here we have the same settings like Azure Active Directory roles. Here you can define, okay, for which role I want to change the settings. In my case, I have the contributor role, I'm sorry. And here you can see I have the same settings available. I have one different part here because I've configured the approval process. I want to show you now the approval process is the same for Azure roles and also for Azure Active Directory roles. Okay, let's switch back to the user side. So here you can see I'm logged in with my test well managed user. Go ahead, go to the Azure AD Privileged Identity Management section here into my roles. And now to my resources, I want to enable my account, my contributor role for this resource group. Same process, validate, my user is validated right now. Select the duration, in this case, a half an hour. Test. Type a reason. Click on activate, and here's the difference now. You can see here activating role, and here you can see your request is pending for approval. So we don't have the three-step workflow here right now. So I'm switched back to my admin session. Go back to the privileged identity management service and click here on approval request. This is a my approval request. And here you can see also the Asia resources. And I have here now one approval request from the user with the recent test PIM demo. I click on the request itself, click on approve, type the justification, in this case, test. Click on confirm. Now the request is approved. From the user perspective, it takes some time, 10 up to 20 seconds, to enable the role, to enable the option to add to view and to change the resources in the resource group. So we will refresh the browser in a few seconds. Here we are. We have the permission. When we click on the resource group, we see the resource group and also have the right permission. Okay, this is an additional error. Now it's gone. We have the correct permission. So we have the contributor permission for this resource group and can work the next half an hour inside this resource group. Okay, that's it. That's from my session, Privileged Identity Management, a feature from Asia Premium 2. I hope you enjoyed the session. I hope you liked the session. Give me a feedback and I will see you soon.